Okay, I kind of forgot to take any video of my progress so far, but this is the update on my head gaskets on the 97 Impreza with the EJ25D. Right now, I am 2 bolts away from pulling the motor, obviously, as you can fucking see it. I just have to pull the bell housing bolt that's on the starter right here, and then the other top bell housing bolt. I already did the bottom two, and it only has the 4, it doesn't have 8. It should be a real simple process. I left most of the accessories on it, obviously, except for the AC and the power steering, because I can't leave them on. I'm doing an AC delete on this car. I already took the whatever condenser, that radiator thing, I took it out. I don't know what it's called. I never use my AC, even in the summer, so I took it out, took all the hosing out. I'm going to change my console so my AC button does something else. I can have it do anything. It'll be pretty cool. I think it'll be neat, some whatever. But yeah, I'm doing the head gaskets on this. It started overheating when I was riding on the interstate. Only like maintain 65 miles an hour, it'll still overheat. And crank up the heater, and it'll kind of play nice. The temperature kind of goes down. I thought it was the radiator, so I replaced the radiator. I have a performance one now. I have one out of 2.5 RS. So it's made for this motor, but so many people on forums and stuff said that the radiator that was in it before should have worked because it was oversized for the EJ22, but I didn't care. I replaced the radiator, I replaced the thermostat. It's still overheated, so I'm just going to do the head gaskets. I don't know if they had been done before. I would assume they haven't because it's overheating, and this was the same exact stuff that happened on my 97 Outback that was overheating. It's behaving exactly the same way. Overheating on short drives, overheating just when I run it a little bit harder, and so I'm doing the head gaskets. I probably won't have the valve seals replaced because that's like extra money I don't want to pay, and I don't know. I have them. They came in the kit. I don't know. I'll have to get into it and see. I'll have to call the shop and see how much it'll cost them to do it. I'm having the heads machined. We have a Napa Auto Parts in town that has a machine shop in it that does it. I'll ask them about the valve seals and see how much the valve linings might be. I don't have those, so I'd have to buy them. Whatever those, the valve guides. I might have to replace those. Just to know that they're better. I have a new timing belt for this. I did not do new idlers. I'm not going to do idlers because I don't want to. This motor only has 160,000 on it, and I'll look at them. I'll listen to them. If they sound like junk, then I'll go for it. But I'm kind of pressed on time, so I don't want to order them and it take 3 weeks, and then I'm screwed out of a car for the winter. I mean, it's snowing like crazy. Not like crazy, but it's been snowing. That's the update on that. Another surprise is that I got rid of my XR600, and I got this. This is a 2000 BMW R1100 RT. RT? RS? I don't remember. I don't care. It's fun. I have the locking bags that go on the side. I have the saddlebags for it. And it's got, like, heated grips and, like, I don't know. It has this thing that tells you what gear you're in. It's pretty quick. I've done 100 on it easily. I got it as a touring bike. I plan to cover some states this summer. And this bike will be awesome. As you can see, it has a whole lot of miles. Almost 209,000. Quite a lot into this bike. It's got some minor flaws. The headlight is cracked and it needs paint on the front from all the wear and tear. But it's got some neat stuff too. It was powder coated black. All of the lower control arms, all of the lower drive shaft, the rims, everything was powder coated black. The valve covers. It's pretty cool. I like the way it looks. It's all black on black, murdered out. It's pretty sweet. Obviously, I still have the R6, still have the Shadow 1100, still working on those. I still have this stupid DR350. I don't even know what I'm doing with that. I'm trying to trade it for like a Toyota pickup truck, four-wheel drive. Because got stuck in the snow the other day. Not in this, but in some shitty car. But yeah, that's kind of what we're going. What's going on at the moment. Updates later. Alright, YouTube. Here it is. Seriously, those just those two bolts. And it's coming up out of here. I tried to put the phone down and see if I can do this. Try to prop it up on this hammer. I don't know if this is gonna work.
Sorry.
This is like the main reason I never film me doing anything, because I don't have a way to put my phone down. Now if this toolbox doesn't fall over, this will work.
Sweet.
So the method I did was where I jacked up the transmission and raised the whole engine and transmission together to get the subframe, or to get the motor mounts up out of the subframe, and then I just pulled it away from the bell housing and lift it straight up and over the front of the car. Real easy. So I was just moving. I'm going to back the car out of the garage because I have all these fucking bikes on the way and I need to get them out of my roommate's parking spaces. So it's just going to sit out there until I get the heads machined and then put back on and put the motor back on. Then I'll pull the car back in, or push the car back in. good the audio is, so I'm just going to come closer to the phone. Sweeping for a couple reasons. I don't know who that is. I'm about to put the engine on the engine stand, and when I'm working on the engine, I want to be able to tell if anything falls off of it. All of the car was like pretty nasty. It had snowed, so and I like plowed through some deep snow, so the whole undercarriage was completely covered in ice and sand and crap. So it all melted and landed on the garage, so I'll sweep it out. That is pretty freaking sweet. The car is like really high off the ground now. I wish it was that high all the time. Do you see this? Oh man, that would be sweet.